hear some concerning things over from Bright Falls.
You mean that horrible affair at the lodge? Why is everyone running around shooting at everything nowadays?
I thought small towns like ours were supposed to be safe.
Oh! Hello, Mare Setter. Nice to meet you. Well, that's the cutest mare I've ever seen, for sure.
Bailey ran around the corner as the street lamps flickered and went off. It was in front of him, a glitching cloud, a dark, boiling monster. Looking at it felt like what a stroke must feel like. He was sick with fear. He fell. The dark presence ripped into him, swallowed him, filled his lungs and his brains with dark water. Bailey saw a snarling face in the darkness. Then he realized it was his own face. He was snarling. He was standing in the street in the dark, and he was snarling. He was snarling, he snarled. The monster was gone. The darkness coiled around him in tatters and wisps. He was the monster now filled with rage. He was the monster now filled with rage, he shouted.
Another cult stash?
Left lung!
Where'd it go? More of those rhymes. Yes.
Hey, another charm.
This bridge got fixed quick.
Animals stayed away from the water's edge as if to avoid some unseen submerged predator waiting just below the dark surface. They never drank the water from the lake. Birds flew around it, never over. Darkness flowed from Cauldron Lake. Gaze in the black mirror of the lake, you'd see it all around you, and you'd understand. It was already out, already where you were. It was already too late. Cauldron Lake used to be alive with people. Beautiful forests, hiking trails leading to stunning vistas. Then the government put up a fence, kept the people out. Volcanic gas, they said. They didn't want anyone knowing the truth. The lake wasn't a lake at all. The dark water a mask to hide the hungry, bottomless ocean below. A fence couldn't stop the flood that was coming. Nothing could. The return of the nightmare rising from the depths.
Another cult box. Can't be opened on this side. Another Alex Casey lunchbox? Rose did all this for me. She completely believes that I am the hero in Wake's story. She should be a bit more critical of a person who tries to control people's lives. another rhyme. And another charm. Witchfinder's Station. I've been there before. Worth checking out. What if I take the weird doll to the place it's not supposed to go? What's the worst that can happen? Actually kind of cute the longer you look at them. Hate to see them like this.
and told her not to stand out in the light she brings. While the loving mother and her hatchling only tried to survive. When a tricky witch opened the way into the dark lake, our hero, against all caution, gave a full step take. Away from the sun, which would make her blind to all that she could see. On our hero, the faraway father still kept an eye and told her not to stand out in the light. While the loving mother and her hatchling only tried to survive. When a tricky witch opened the way into the dark lake, our hero, against all caution, gave a bold step take. Away from the sun, which would make her blind to all that she could see. On our hero, the faraway father still kept an eye. And told her not to stand out in the light too bright. While the loving mother and her hatchling only tried to survive. When a tricky witch opened the way into the dark lake.
What the?
Hello, are you receiving me? I'm talking to you, ma'am.
Who is this? How do you know I'm here?
I've been wondering your incessant tampering with my project. You have made some advantageous progress, however.
What project?
What project? So you've just been playing around with my test arrangements with absolutely no understanding of their function. The hubris.
Indeed.
But your interference with my research has come to its conclusion. I'm interested to see the results. The trick, I believe, is a manifestation of the nursery rhyme. Art becoming reality, with the doorway being revealed and, or perhaps even someone entering it.
Get to the point.
Middleton and Rude, I see. The point is that by your unwanted actions, you may have opened the way. And now I'll get to observe what exactly occurs when a subject crosses the threshold. No, wait, that's not right. What is that?
Hello? Hey, are you there? Sounds like this person got more than they bargained for. Ugh, this stuff again. There's something else in here. This will be handy. There's a lesson here. Probably something about hubris. Man in lab coat messes around and finds out. Called it.
They think they're so mysterious, they're ridiculous masks. Children in costumes.
Oh, hello there.
Ed hadn't been the same since his latest show had closed. This wasn't the first time one of his productions had shuttered early. Scathing social commentary in a one-act play wasn't exactly filling seats. When Tammy told him she was taking a research trip to Bright Falls, he decided to tag along. Ed told her he wanted to find inspiration. Really, he just wanted a break from the city. But it was true that he certainly needed to find something. A voice. A direction. An idea. Something authentic to himself. Ed knew he couldn't keep using Tammy's money to fund his playwriting. After the argument with Tammy, Ed stormed out of the diner and drove their rental car back to Cauldron Lake to prove a point. Now standing in the dark woods, the sun hidden by the trees, Ed wished he could remember what that point was. Something about masculinity. He cursed at himself and turned to go. Suddenly, he was blinded by a light in his face. Voices shouted and hands pushed him to the ground. Ed struggled in vain. Tammy tapped her pen on her notebook. Alan Wake had ridden this same ferry into town when he arrived. This was his entry into Bright Falls. His first steps across the threshold. She wrote that down. She always found it helpful to walk in the victim's shoes, do what they did, see what they saw. It added great color to the book. Tammy felt raindrops on her face. God, again? She pulled up her hood. The rain just kept coming. She missed New York. So far, this hadn't been the simple research trip she pictured. First the incident at the lake, then the fight with Ed. It's not surprising tempers got hot. They were both on edge after what had happened. Tammy had said some things she regretted. She looked out over the harbor. A chill passed through her. She hoped Ed wouldn't do anything stupid.